got my prickly linkage and triangle yesterday. So now it's time to install that Fox Float rear shock. So I wanted to do an install video, but as you guys can hear and see, my neighbor decided to have a cement truck come today, and it's pretty loud, so I'm gonna try and take it from the garage inside the living room since my wife is currently gone. So that's what we're gonna do. Take all this stuff inside, get this thing set up. All right, so I got the shock a couple weeks ago, and I just got the prickly stuff this week, so time to do the install. Let me kind of explain what I've already done. First thing I did when I got the shock was to put in the max amount of the volume spacers. So the package came with four of them. I had already ordered these extras here. There's three extras in there. From what I read, it said the max is five. Now, when I took this apart, I could only figure out how to get four on there. There's spacers in between. There's like a little metal rib around it. And I could only get one spacer in each of those metal ribs. So I'm running it with four right now. I might take it off and try and squeeze another one in there if I bottom out. But what I did to do that, there's some other videos online if you want to look it up, but I put a little eyeglasses screwdriver, popped out this silver retention ring, and then the sleeve slides off and you can get to the volume spacers. I should mention, first you gotta take all the air pressure out. There's a little Schrader valve, there's a cover on it right there that I've already taken off. You let all the air out right there and then you can work on it. So, next thing we're gonna do is to take off the stock one. So let's get to it. All right, so first step to take off the old shock here is to adjust this ring here and let all the, you know, take all the settings down to the loosest, adjust that ring so you got all the slack out of the spring that you can. And then we're gonna start to take off the linkage bolts here. All right, we got a 6mm Allen key on this side. We got a 14mm socket on this side. So let's go ahead and take all these off, starting with this center one. This bottom one here is blocked by the little chain guard. Looks like I'm gonna have to go get a flat wrench to get to that one. So I'll be back. All right, so that bottom one was pretty much impossible to get off in place, but luckily after I took off the rest of them, the whole thing was able to slide out with the linkage still attached at that bottom. So that's how to do it. All right, now I got that out. I guess I could just leave that on there, but there's the old linkage. There's the old shock. I'll put that in my box of spare parts. Next thing I gotta do is take off the other two bolts for the stock triangle. So we'll get that. All right, had my camera run out of batteries, so I charged that for a while, went and mailed out a speedometer relocation bracket to Thomas, so thank you Thomas from California. So also what I did, you see I took out the stock triangle, installed that prickly triangle. Take a look at the difference in thickness there. So, shouldn't have to worry about that one breaking. So, I also installed the shock onto the prickly linkage. That was that Allen head that I couldn't get to when it was on the bike. So what I used to do that, you'll have to buy two of these. It's the 8mm by 23.8mm bushings. So I already installed it here on the bottom. I'll show you how to install it on the top here. All right, so that bushing kit is gonna come with two of the cream spacers, then you got a thick black one, one with little bumps here, and then a rubber O-ring, and then your bushing here. So my shock was new. I got the cream ones already on there. So what I did on the bottom, shove that black one through there. And then I went, kind of get it, make sure it's even there both sides. Then I went rubber, and then the thick spacer. Actually, this one looks like it's a little bit thicker than the bottom. I might not need all three. Oh no, never mind. Just didn't have it pushed in all the way. Okay, so rubber O-ring, then thick spacer, then the thin spacer with the bumps facing out. Same thing on the other side. Rubber, then thick, then the bumps facing out there. Then, make sure we got that top. So now I'm gonna feed that through the new triangle there into place. You know what? Actually, I'm gonna brush out those holes a little bit first. They got some sand and stuff in them, so I'm gonna try and clean those out with a little pipe cleaner or something first. Got everything cleaned up a little bit. I'm gonna go ahead and put a little dab of the blue Loctite on there. Come on now. Now I'm gonna fish this top one through first. That's right, I was gonna thread it the whole way. You recall that now. There we go. Just didn't have it lined up. Okay. And this one here to the triangle. And that's lined up. Fits right in there. Whoops. Forgot the Loctite. I'm not gonna go all the way tight. Still need to get this middle one. All right, so I got it connected to the top up here. I got it connected to the triangle here, but you'll see the shock is compressed. It doesn't have any air in it, so it's not gonna reach where I need to connect it there. So what I'm gonna have to do take off the valve cover here, connect my shock pump, and that start pumping it up a little bit. So I can get it to, all right, that's about 150. Let's see if I can get that in place now. Put that on there backwards today. Stand by. The answer is no, I did not put it on backwards. It's just, I need to support the bottom wheel since it's on the stand, so. Hope I can get it in there. Oh yeah, I should be able to hold that up and slide it in there. All right, so we'll see if I can kind of hold this into place. Tight on the nut, put it back on. Now let's tighten them all up. That bottom one's already tight, but tighten these two up. Installed. Max air pressure on this shock is 300. I'm going to go up to about 250 first. Give that a test. Oops. Just let some pressure out there. About 200 right there. So again, I put four volume spacers in there, which is all I could get to fit in. Thought I read that the max spacer for this length was 5. This is the 10.5 by 3.5. But I could only get 4 in there. So I'm gonna check and see if it gets close to bottoming them out. And I might try and get that fifth one in there, but I think it's gonna do good with the 4. And maybe the 2020 and earlier could do 5, and this is the 2021, I don't know. All right, that's about 250 right there. Take the pump off here. Put the cap back on. And the last thing here, I took this brake cable guide off when I was trying to get to that bottom. So I gotta put that back on. I think that was 3mm, I think. Anyway, didn't need to take it off. Just leave that bottom piece of the linkage attached to the shock and pull the whole thing out through the triangle instead of trying to mess around for 20 minutes like I did, trying to get the bottom one off in place. So I hope this video helps someone out, in that respect at least. All right. That's it. So I haven't changed any of the settings or anything. But, ooh, wow. That is so much bouncier. Wow. So let's see. Without anything adjusted, this is 250 PSI, 4 volume spacers. Well, really, I don't have a battery in here and I'm not dressed, but I'm just gonna see what the kind of sag is. You know, kind of right there. Yeah, it's already using up about half the travel. So anyway, I'm gonna mess with the compression settings. Maybe pump it up a little bit more too, because that seems a little bit too cushy. Like I said, I don't got the battery in it yet. Well, when I reconnected the pump, it's showing about 150 PSI, so no wonder. I adjusted all the compression and rebound settings that were shown in the tuning manual for 290 PSI. So that was, I turned them all the way closed, which is clockwise, and then there was high speed and low speed compression, high speed and low speed rebound. They were all about 1 to 2 clicks open. So there I got it back up to 200 PSI. So I think it's just equalizing. What I need to do is kind of get it up to where I want it, bounce it a couple times. Oh yeah, that's way stiffer right there. That feels way better. Yeah, I think it just wasn't equalized through the chambers the first time. I pumped it up to 250 and then I didn't bounce it around first, so now it's pumped up to 250 again right now, and it's feels about perfect. Let's see what my sag is. Again, I don't have battery in. I'm obviously not in riding gear. I'm about 175 right now, and that's still using half the travel, so I am gonna pump it up to 300. Or at least 250, that's down at 200 again. All right, so I let it equalize. I put the battery back in and I pumped it up about 275. Seems to be about the right sag, but again, I've got no riding gear on. I usually have a little backpack with some water. So I think maybe 285 is where I'm gonna leave it. I don't wanna go all the way up to 300 just yet. So feels really good at 275. It felt, you know, a little bit stiffer than the stock with, you know, the 450-pound spring in it. So again, I didn't really bottom that one out too many times. Maybe once or twice, but this one should be an upgrade for sure. So can't wait to take it out, test it.